got big news. This is it. This is the final episode.
It's the end of an era for many fans of The Daily Show with Jon Stewart as the popular host said goodbye to the show that made him a household name. While billed as a comedy, in its more than 16 years on the air, The Daily Show became a news source for Americans who favored Stewart's well-researched current events segments that viewers found funny as well as hugely informative. It also launched the careers of many comedians like Steve Carell, Stephen Colbert, and Ed Helms. Helms, who stars in Warner Brothers' Vacation, talked to us about how Stewart's The Daily Show changed his life.
It really wasn't until I worked on The Daily Show that I learned how much discipline and hard work it takes to work in this business. And The Daily Show was such an incredible boot camp training session for me. I owe everything to The Daily Show.
Through his years on the air, Stewart exposed ineptitudes in politics, showbiz, and media. He frequently made fun of news broadcasting gimmicks and partisan reporting.
Giant floor maps, big fake airplanes, little fake airplanes, holographic airplanes, no airplane detail left unspoken.
Stewart's Comedy Central show became a must-visit for politicians wanting to reach out to his audience. Though acknowledged as a gifted comic, the host oftentimes delivered serious speeches and monologues to make his viewers hear beyond sound bites.
Why would you work with Marxists actively subverting our Constitution, or racists and homophobes who see no one's humanity but their own?
South African comedian Trevor Noah will be the new host of The Daily Show beginning September 28th, filling the big shoes left behind by Jon Stewart. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.